In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient words impart.
For our Goodnight message on this Friday, the 28th of April 2023, broadcasting from Kasama, Zambia, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to the lessons from the conversion of Saul. Today we read from the lengthy passage of the story of the conversion of Saul. This is one of the most eye-opening and most powerful conversions ever recorded in the Bible. Though all of our conversions are equally powerful and individually special in the sight of God, one cannot help but recognize the great things we can learn from Saul's conversion. The first thing we can learn is that God can save anyone, even the most antagonistic to the faith. We understand that Saul was a fervent persecutor of those who followed the Lord Jesus Christ. We read in the passage we had today that he was on the way to another location in the crackdown against the followers of the way, but the Lord had another plan for him. Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Such was Saul's famous antagonism towards the faith that even the church couldn't believe he could be saved. In the 6 verses that follow after the passage that we read today, that is Acts chapter 9 verse 26, we read, "And when Saul had come to Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him and did not believe that he was a disciple." Is there anyone we deem unsavable? God is able to save anyone who draws near to him. In this case, those who respond to him when he calls them. The second lesson we learn is that our salvation should make us realize how blind we were before Christ saved us. Saul literally went blind after his encounter with Christ. This man was perfectly healthy, lost sight after seeing just how glorious, holy, and majestic God is. This reminds us of Job, who said of the Lord, "I have heard of you by the hearing of the ear, but now my eye sees you. Therefore I abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes." Job 42 verse 5 to 6. The truth is, whenever we get a glimpse of God or see him, we recognize our smallness in comparison to his greatness. We see our dirt in comparison to his purity. We recognize our unrighteousness in comparison to his righteousness. Our salvation in Christ makes us realize just how depraved and lost we are without him. Before we met him, we used to think that we are okay, that we are good, even great. When we meet him, however, we see our inability to save ourselves and to make ourselves right with God. We realize just how blinded we were by sin the moment he opens our eyes. The third lesson we learn is that we are saved from something and for something. When we read the passage we had today, we can notice that Saul was saved from something and for something. He was given a new direction. We read in Acts chapter 9 verse 6 onwards the things that happened to Saul after meeting Christ. He was humbled, freed from the blindness caused by sin, given a new life, empowered by the Holy Spirit, preached the gospel, and went on serving Christ even when he was persecuted. He then went on to become one of the key movers of the gospel, planting churches everywhere he goes and writing several of the books in the New Testament. God didn't just save him from something, God saved him for something. And the same is true for all of us. When God saved us from sin, Satan, and hell, he also saved us for holiness, himself, and heaven. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
Changing me and changing you, we have come.